Hello everyone and welcome to this Moodle Academy webinar, Introduction to Moodle 4. We're very pleased to be with you today. I'm Mary Cooch, Education Manager at Moodle HQ, and I'm going to be presenting alongside Helen Foster, who's the Moodle Community Team Lead at Moodle HQ. And together, we're going to be talking to you about the new features and improvements in Moodle 4. Now, we're very excited to talk to you about Moodle 4, a new journey for us. I think no one would have any doubts that Moodle is the most powerful learning management system in the world in terms of its features and functionalities. Certainly, if it's not a standard feature, you can have it as a contributed feature. And this is a great benefit, although it can mean that for some teachers and learners, Moodle can sometimes be a little bit daunting or overwhelming. And with Moodle 4 and subsequent 4 releases, we are making UX our highest priority because we want to have Moodle as a very, very powerful and feature-rich learning management system, but one that is very simple and smooth to navigate. And hopefully, as you watch our presentation on the new features and improvements in Moodle 4, you will see the beginnings of the progress that we are making in focusing on UX in terms of the navigation. So let's begin. We're going to do this presentation in 4 parts. So first of all, Helen is going to talk to you about site administration, the new features, changes and improvements there. And then I'm going to look at the navigation, mainly from the student point of view, what teachers see, how they edit a course, and then going specifically into improvements in course activities and other settings relating to activities and resources. And we will pause after each of these sections to monitor the chat and to respond to any questions or comments. So I'm now going to pass over to you, Helen, to talk about what's new in site administration.
Thanks, Mary. Well, first off, site admin presets. These enable administrators to configure their site in a couple of clicks. The feature is based on the additional plugin admin presets created by David Monlau and maintained by developers from Pimenco. 2 presets are available in Moodle 4.0 for admins to choose from, starter or full. The starter preset has lots of features turned off to make Moodle simpler to begin with. The admin can enable more features at any time or switch to a different preset such as full, which is the default site admin configuration. And as well as being able to apply the starter or full presets, admins can create their own site admin presets to export and use elsewhere or share with others. So here's how things look in a course when you've applied the starter preset. The activity chooser has a lot less activities to confuse you. No chat, database activity, IMS content package or survey. Then when adding a new question to the quiz, you also have less to choose from. Just the popular question types, such as multiple choice, true, false, etc. Talking of questions, new in Moodle 4.0 is a question bank plugin type and lots of extra features such as question versioning and question statistics. The Question Bank Improvements Project is funded and supported by a number of European universities and is continuing in Moodle 4.1. One new feature which you may find useful if you've hundreds of questions to organize is the ability to set up question custom fields, which then appear as a column in the question bank. More on this from Mary shortly. Another feature is being able to define the order of columns in the question bank. Remember too that each feature is now a plugin which you can disable if you don't want to use it. Thus, if you know that teachers on your site will not be interested in statistics such as discriminative efficiency, you can simply disable it. Custom reports. In Moodle 4.0, you can create your own custom reports of users, courses, or cohorts, thanks to the Moodle Workplace feature Report Builder, which is now included in Moodle LMS. After creating a report, you can then specify who should receive it, such as all users with the role of manager, and set a schedule of how often the report will be generated. LTI 1.3 Advantage Tool Provider. Moodle 4.0 takes interoperability one step further by moving from LTI 1.1 to 1.3 Advantage Standard. The benefits of 1.3 Advantage over 1.1 include dynamic registration, assignment and grade services, that's syncing grades and results to the gradebook, and name and role provisioning services, that's sharing of roster or enrollment information. Primary navigation options. In Moodle 4.0, at the top of each page, we have links to Home, Dashboard, and My Courses, and also site administration if you're an admin. If you decide that users on your site don't need a dashboard, maybe your site offers self-paced courses without dates, so no need for a timeline block or calendar, then you can disable the dashboard and set either My Courses or Home as the start page where users are redirected to after logging in. If you want to make more changes to this primary navigation, such as maybe hiding the home link, you're able to do so in the theme config file. Blocks cleanup. So, as well as adding lots of new features to Moodle 4.0, we've also looked to improve the user experience by simplifying some areas. One area is the add a block menu in a course. In Moodle 3.11, the menu is really long and includes many blocks which a teacher would never want to use. We've shortened this list as follows. If a feature is disabled in the site admin, then blocks which use this feature are also disabled. This makes sense, doesn't it? For example, if you disable blogs in advanced features, then the blog menu, blog tags, and recent blog entry blocks are automatically disabled too and won't be shown in the add a block menu. Secondly, some blocks are disabled by default. These are the course summary block, feedback block, which is only for when a feedback activity is added to the homepage, remote RSS feeds, since RSS feeds are not used so much these days, and self-completion, as this block is only needed if self-completion is used for course completion. Finally, there's a new admin setting for themes to define unneeded blocks. For example, Boost doesn't need the navigation or administration blocks. They're only for the classic theme. It also doesn't need courses block because we have the My Courses page, or the section links block as the course index provides access to sections. Finally, not about site admin, but for everybody, we have some Atto accessibility improvements. Kindly funded by the Moodle Users Association. Firstly, there are more announcements for screen readers, including when you encounter the Atto text editor and also whether a button is applying or removing a style. Secondly, the accessibility checker and the screen reader helper buttons are now on the first row of the toolbar, so you don't need to use the button Show More buttons to access them. Okay, that's all from me. Any questions in the chat before I hand over to you, Mary?
Right, thank you. So should we take a look at the chat and see if there are any questions? Lots of people saying hello from lots of different parts of the world here, which is really good to know. We've got Romania, we've got Nova Scotia, we've got Cape Town. I'm not seeing any questions. San Francisco, Brazil, but it's possible that questions will arise as we move further through the presentation. Pakistan. Yeah, I'm fascinated. Switzerland. Okay, Mars. Wow, I think you might be the furthest person there from Mars. Let's continue.
And oh, wait a minute. I noticed one question. Ian is asking, did I say that RSS block was gone completely? No. It's just disabled in the site administration so that it doesn't appear in a course for teachers. But if you want to use it on your site, it's very easy. You just go in as a site admin and enable it or unhide it again, and then it will reappear in that add a block menu. And Nelson is asking, does every admin setting can be set from the preset admin page? I'm not exactly sure what you're asking, but nearly every site admin setting is saved when you create an admin preset and can be transferred to another site. There's just, I think capabilities cannot be saved, but we have other ways for sharing role definitions.
I've just noticed James saying, my Boost theme has my courses menu empty. Am I missing a setting? I'm wondering if to see something on the My Courses page, you need to be enrolled as a teacher or a student in courses. The admin might not necessarily see any, if that's possible.
Beau says, it seems like on the Moodle demo site, the accessibility is not on the third row. It is as it was. I'm not sure which demo site you mean, but whatever, when you upgrade your site, any changes that you made previously are remembered, so that's how it is when you've upgraded. So it's possible that those buttons in Atto are from previously. We'll have to check that afterwards.
Yes, I think you're saying school.moodledemo.net, Bob. Well, we can do that afterwards. Yes.
Okay. Thank you for pointing that out. Alex is asking, can other themes set unneeded blocks? Well, certainly the setting is for each theme. So I just mentioned the unneeded blocks for Boost, but Classic can also set unneeded blocks, or if you have a custom theme, you should have those settings there as well.
Okay, any others, or shall we move on? Plenty of time afterwards to ask questions. Okay then, so moving from site administration, we're now going to look at what Moodle 4 is like for a course and from the point of view of a student navigating. And to do that, I'm going to take you on a virtual tour of a Moodle site. And so we're going to log in with student Paula's login. And the first thing you might notice here is the background image. So the administrator can now, if desired, add a background image to the improved login screen. You might want to do this to tie in your login screen with your organization's branding, or simply to make it look pretty. So when our student logs in, she will see, as Helen has already mentioned, at the top here, some primary navigation, home to your front page, dashboard, which is this, which I'll talk about in a moment, My Courses, a brand new page, and site administration if you're the administrator. Now, the dashboard, you'll see that the timeline is there and it has been improved. So our student can easily see what she needs to do. For example, she needs to add a submission. It's on the right, attempt a quiz. She can see the times. Our student is quite an organized student, so she hasn't got anything overdue. But if she did, it would have a big red overdue button there to clearly show that she was late. And she can also search by activity type or name. Also on a Moodle 4 default dashboard is an improved calendar. And you'll see over in the block drawer here, as we call it, the recently accessed items block. So that makes it easy for her to pick up where she left off when she next logs into Moodle. And if you're thinking, but where are the courses? My dashboard has the course overview block. That is actually now in its own special page, the My Courses page. And here you will see courses that you're enrolled in, as our student Paula can, and she sees the completion. She can sort the courses, she can have card or list view. And we're going to go into this course, Mindful Course Creation, for the first time since the site was upgraded to Moodle 4. So if we click to enter this course on a Moodle 4 site, you'll see that she has a user tour. And in fact, there are four new user tours for Moodle 4, which is a nice matching number. And you might also notice that this tour includes a graphic. So if you're an administrator and you like user tours, you can now add graphics to your user tours. So she's just going to click to close the user tour so that we can explore this front page more. And if she or you actually wants to replay or reset the user tour, then notice bottom right, the question mark icon. And when you click this, you can reset the user tour. And also, depending on your roles and permissions around the site, you'll see other links too. So Paula has a link to contact site support. The contact support contact email is now obligatory. You have to enter something there as an administrator or have a contact support form. And this is where Paula can go to contact site support. If you are a teacher in a course, this question mark icon, if you click it, will also take you to the links to documentation. So we'll just close that and we'll take a look at how the course is made up. So on the left, we have what we call the course index, replacing the boost navigation drawer, where you can see the sections and the different activities. And this course index scrolls independently of the main course page. So you can scroll this differently, separately from the course index. And the sections, which are in bold in the course index, they can be collapsed to free up space and allow you to focus on one particular section. You can collapse them individually, or by clicking the collapse all here, you can collapse them all, as you can see here. And this is really useful for our student Paula to be able then just to open one and focus on one section to make sure she's completing the required activity and to help her track her progress. So if we open one of these sections, you'll see over on the right, and she's indeed a very organized student, because these on the right are the completion requirement buttons. And she's completed all of these. They are done. They're in green. So if you use activity completion, notice that those requirements have moved over to the right. And in fact, the activities themselves are in cards, as we call them, cards here, neatly displayed. But to make progress tracking even better for learners, if you look to the left into the course index, you'll see some circles. They are blank or not filled in if she hasn't completed an activity. And they're filled in, they're green here, if she has. These are called completion indicators. And again, because she can scroll the course index separately from the course main page, she can very quickly scroll up and down and see what she's completed, all of these, and what she still has to do. Now, the course index can be collapsed by clicking the X. And you see there's a lot of space there. And she can open it again. She can expand it. And then if we look over to the right here, if the teacher has added blocks to this course, then our student can click to open the block drawer and see what extra blocks with extra learning information is there. So if we click to open the block drawer, indeed, the teacher has added some blocks. In fact, he's added a block with his own picture and information about himself teaching the course, which I think perhaps is a good point at which we'll pause just for a moment before we go in and look at Moodle as a teacher and see if there are any questions about what you've seen so far in terms of the new navigation.
Thanks, Mary. Just looking at the chat, Vismanath is asking, what's the top priority audience in 4.x? Well, when we do user research testing, we try and have as many people from different organizations as possible, because we don't have a priority audience. We aim to develop features that could be used by all different users of Moodle.
Tracy says, so glad to see expandable collapsible sections on course home pages. Yes, it's a nice feature, definitely.
Omid is asking, is there a way to have sections introduced in the course available to users before enrolling in the course? For example, here, the section why this course would be very good if available before enrolment. Coursera has this feature. Well, we don't have a specific feature for enabling a section to be available before the users enroll in the course, though you can always use your course description field to add information about why this course is there. If you want more functionality, I'd encourage you to post in Moodle.org in the usability area suggesting this, and see whether there are others who would agree and would like to expand on the idea.
Yes, there are some workarounds, aren't there? I mean, you could have the top section of your course open to guests, and then have to use restrict access to restrict the rest of it to someone with an email address, because obviously if you have an email address, that means you're logged in and enrolled. But again, it's not specific to Moodle 4, but it's something we're happy to discuss in the forums. Bob is saying, does this mean the progress bar in the topic title section will no longer be visible to users? I'm not quite sure what you mean there, Bob. If do you know, Helen? The progress
bar in the topic
title section.
Maybe it's some customization that Bo is using. Juan is asking, I would like to know if the classical left navigation drawer was completely removed, the one that had links to site home, dashboard, site administration, private files, etc. Was it replaced by the new course index feature and relocated to the top of the page? Yeah, that's basically how it is, that we don't have a navigation drawer anymore. And instead we have the what's called the primary navigation along the top to your site homepage, dashboard, and a new My Courses page that sort of replaced the course index that we had before. And your private files, as before, you can access them via your user menu.
Okay, Pablo is saying, will site home page be available? Well, site home, I think you mean the front page of your Moodle site. If you do show your Moodle site, then I think that is called home. So that's the first of the links in the primary navigation, which you saw when we were demonstrating. Not all sites show it. For example, Moodle Cloud sites just have the login page. So let's go in now as our teacher and look at the course from a course editing point of view. So the first thing to notice is top right there, you have edit mode toggle on and off. So no more the turn editing on button or the turn editing on link. That's a very quick way of enabling editing. You'll also notice that we have just underneath the title here, course navigation. So the student has some of this. The student had participants and grades. Our teacher has more, so settings, that's where the teacher can go in and change, for example, the short full name of the course or the start end dates, grades, reports, and an important more link, which is worth exploring. So if we click the more link, you'll see this is where you will find the new improved question bank, which I'm going to talk about later, the H5P content bank, and a new link at the bottom here, course reuse. I wanted to point this out because this is where you will find links such as course backup, course restore, course reset, course import. They are all in the course reuse link. Okay. So I think we left our students, didn't we? We left our students looking at blocks. So now that our teacher has turned on editing or enabled editing, then he can click the block drawer and go to add a block. So you see in the block drawer, my number one, add a block, he's already clicked it. Hence this block list is highlighted. And as Helen mentioned, don't be surprised if you don't see all the blocks you're expecting because of the new way of managing and not showing certain blocks in administration. But it's important to realize that if you use the English language pack, then the HTML block has been renamed to text block. This is to make it more understandable for teachers who think, oh, I don't know any HTML, this isn't for me. It is basically just a block where you can add text or images or media. In fact, the Your Teacher block here is an example of a text block. So we'll just leave that and we'll go back into the course. We have edit mode on, as you can see, top right. And with the student, we were looking at the fact that you can collapse and expand sections. This is useful for when you want to move sections around because you can move around by drag and drop. So for example, in the course index, if we simply dragged the Why This Course section, which is collapsed, we can simply drag it to underneath Mindful Teaching and it's done. And you can drag and drop sections and activities both in the course index and also in the course central area. And in fact, something else which you might like, if you have a very long course with many activities, because you can scroll the course index separately from the course main page, if you just scroll and put your course index in the section or the location where you want to move something to, then you just find it on the course main page. You can drag it from the course main page into the course index and move it very quickly like that. And we still have the older way of moving things. So we've a lot of improvements in drag and drop. But if you click any of the three dots, you'll see that you can still click move there and you will be presented with the different sections and you can select where you want to move it there. And these options and the improved drag and drop also apply to activities as well. So for example, if we wanted to move this H5P activity, how mindful an educator are you? We can move it up and down in the course in the course main page, or we can move it from the course index or into the course index. And as you scroll down the activities in the course main page, the course central area, then they are highlighted in the course index, as you can see here. And if we click on an activity, let's click on this H5P activity in the course index, you will see that it opens up immediately in the course main area for easy access for the student to attempt it. And also from the teacher's point of view, you will see that the activity navigation is now present here. So having clicked into the activity, here's one way of accessing the activity navigation. Now, if you're wondering, well, how do I get back to the course page now? If you look at MCC 2022, that's actually the short name of this Mindful Course Creation course. And you just need to click the short name of your course and it will take you back to the course page. We're going to go back there. And in fact, we're going to scroll down in between two course sections because I would like to show you something else there. You will see add topic. So in Moodle 4, you can add a topic section in between other topic sections. You don't have to scroll all the way down to the end of the page, to the bottom of the page to do it. I think if you're using weekly course format, you do need to add them from the bottom because it would be rather strange to be able to add a week in between two other weeks in a calendar. But this is a very nice feature. And also, if you just look above there, add an activity or resource. This, again, at the bottom of each section, this is where you go to add activities or resources with edit mode on. And if we click, this is going to take us to the activity chooser. And we have new icons for the activity chooser. You'll see that they are colored, and the colors represent the different functions of these activities. So for example, we have pink, which is for assessment, such as an assignment or a quiz. We have blue for content, such as a book or a file or a page. We have green, which I think is communication, chat, for example. And then collaboration in red, such as a wiki or a forum or glossary. So these are the standard icons with their colors. If you're using third-party contributed activities and resources, they might not have these. But one thing I do want to point out is the icon big blue button, because as part of looking at the improvements to activities in Moodle, we're going to focus on big blue button. But for now, we're just going to leave it there. And before we go into that final section, let's see if there are any questions again in the chat relating to what we've just seen of Moodle 4 from the teacher's point of view.
Thanks, Mary. A question from Louis saying, site home and my dashboard pages are different. Are they both still available in Moodle 4? Well, the site home page is still the same. But the dashboard is a tiny bit different, because in 3.11 in the dashboard, you have your course overview block, whereas in 4.0, the course overview is now on the My Courses page. So you'll notice that difference, but otherwise you should find the dashboard the same as in 3.11. I should mention also that the timeline block and calendar blocks have been improved. So you should notice those also in your dashboard if you're using them.
Okay. I'm going from the bottom up actually for the questions. Sam says, has the hide but made an activity available changed? No, that hasn't changed. Okay.
Louis is asking, is on 4.0 any workaround to duplicate entire sections like you do with individual activities? For example, reusing sections with the same resource structures. Well, there's nothing new in 4.0 for duplicating entire sections, but you can still do, it's like a workaround as you do in 3.11, which would be to create a backup of, if you say a course backup, and you just select all items within a section.
Okay. Zunara is saying, for the teacher profile blog, can more than one picture and intros be added? Do you mean the blog which is attached to a profile in any Moodle site? In which case, I think, you know, each time you add a blog post, you can add pictures and text. Or were you referring to the block that was in our demonstration course? In which case, again, because it's just a text block, you can add more pictures and more text. Sorry if I didn't understand your question there. Okay.
Lisa is asking about the navigation. Did you answer those questions, Mary?
No, I didn't see that. I'm looking at it.
Two questions about navigation. Firstly, can you add to the primary navigation to include pointers to support documentation, for example? Yep, it's just like in 3.11, the site admin can add custom navigation links along the top there. And then the second question is, can you modify the course navigation to select which of the pages you highlight to the end user? I'm wondering whether you mean, I mean, the course navigation, the course index on the left shows all the items that are available to students. So if you don't want students to access a particular item, then you would hide it, whether it's an activity or resource, the same as in 3.11. Is that what your question is about?
Lisa's saying, yes, we might not want to have the grade book so obvious to staff.
All right, so you mean the navigation when you're on the course page, that navigation that goes across the top with the course and then the course settings and then the grade book. You can hide the grades link in the user menu like we do in 3.11, but we don't have a way in 4.0 to hide that gradebook link in that course navigation.
Okay then. So we're going to take a look now at course activities and then a couple of settings within those activities and also the question bank. So if you remember, we left our teacher just about to add a big blue button activity from the new improved activity chooser. So let's assume that our teacher has added that and go in and find the big blue button room. And so you can see here that in big blue button now, standard in Moodle 4 is free tier hosting for big blue button. And so that means that our teacher can have a live webinar with up to 25 users, and which can be recorded for up to an hour. And those recordings will be saved for a week, for 7 days. And also, of course, as with all big blue buttons, he can share his presentation. He can share his screen. He can use a whiteboard. There's the chat. There is also breakout rooms, polls, and very, very useful analytics. So please do take a look at the course that is attached. So there are two courses which are attached to this presentation. The one that this webinar is taking place in, Moodle 4 for Educators, we talk to you and explain a little bit more about big blue button features there and other aspects as well. So big blue button was one that I wanted to show you. I also wanted to talk a little bit about assignment and a couple of improvements to the assignment activity. So if we join our teacher as he updates an assignment activity, you'll see that as well as the description, which we've had forever, there's now a new box, activity instructions. Now, previously, if you needed to give instructions for an assignment, you put them in the description and then they either displayed on the course page, which was a bit annoying, or they displayed as soon as the student clicked into the assignment. Now, however, if you complete them in the activity instructions box, the student will only see them when they click to begin the assignment, to actually start working on their submission, as we'll see when we look at this assignment from the student's point of view in a moment. Then if we scroll down this assignment editing screen, we come to another new feature, which is a time limit. So just as with the quiz, you can now set a time limit on assignments. You do need to have the admin enable this. It's not enabled by default. The admin needs to turn this feature on in assignment settings, and then you can set a time limit. However, unlike the quiz, it's important to realize if you, as a student, if you go over the time limit, you can still submit. It's not going to cut you off and send it in like the quiz. You can still submit, but when you've submitted, your teacher will see that you sent it in after the time limit. You exceeded the time limit. Now, the next couple of settings that I'd like to show you, I'm using the assignment as my example, but they apply to other activities, not just the assignment. And so the next one applies to all graded activities, and it's perhaps my second favorite feature. And that is that you can now have a passing grade as an activity completion requirement. Now, before this, you've been able to have this for quiz, but now any gradable activity as a completion requirement, you can have a passing grade. This is something that we, in terms of the Moodle Educator Certification, have been hoping for several years now. And scrolling down to the very bottom of this assignment settings page, and in fact, to the bottom of all activities and resources, is definitely my favorite feature, because it's something that people have often been asking for on the Moodle.org forums, and that is send content change notification. Basically, what this means is that when you add an item or you update an item, then if you tick this box, your students will get an alert, either a push notification on their smartphone or a notification on the web, that something has been added or changed, with a link to go there so they can access it. And this is a very, very useful feature. So let's assume that our student Paula has just received one of these notifications telling her that the assignment she needs to do has been updated. If she then clicks the assignment and presses begin assignment, this is what she sees. So here you will see the instructions, the activity instructions, where she can start adding her submission. And over on the right, you will see the timer. So she's obviously just begun because the timer was set to 15 minutes. And that is what it looks like from the student's point of view. So we've looked at Big Blue Button. We've looked at assignments. Something else that's very important that we should look at is improvements to the question bank. Now, if you remember, to get to the question bank in Moodle 4, you need to go to the course navigation and then click more and then click question bank. So we're going to go there now. And you should see some extra columns, which we'll take a look at. And just a reminder, as Helen said, the administrator can decide to reorder and even hide some of these columns. Now, status, ready or draft, if we take that one first. As you create a question in Moodle 4, as a teacher, you can decide whether to mark it as ready. In other words, you think it's fine for you and your colleagues to use immediately in quizzes, or set it to draft because perhaps you're not sure and you would like them to peer review it, perhaps to make a comment on it. And you'll see here we have a comments column where you can view comments on quiz questions. And to the right of that is a very useful column which represents very clearly, graphically and simply, a very complex algorithm, or at least complex to me. This is needs checking. And this will tell you, based on the responses or the performance of students in certain quiz questions, whether your question is not very good and you need to adapt it a little bit, improve it, it very likely needs checking, or whether it's a good question, it's acting as it should, and it's unlikely to need checking. Facility index, discriminative efficiency, the admin has decided to show them here. They're not new, but previously they weren't as visible in statistics. It's now possible to make such columns visible to help people and to give them more usage. And in fact, in terms of usage, this column allows you to see how often your question has been used and where. And then if we move towards the left again, apologies for moving round, I want to look at assessment type. So assessment type is not a column in itself, but this is an example of what Helen was saying is question custom fields. So the administrator, upon requests of teachers, can create custom fields. So for example, when you make questions in this course, you can mark whether you think that they are more useful for summative assessment or more useful for formative assessment. And this is where you can see them in the question bank. And to the right of that, we have versions. So we now have question versioning. For example, if we look at this second one down where my big black arrow is, this has two versions of the question. So if we want to see the history of these questions, we need to click in that actions column, and then we click history, And this will take us to the question history of that one particular question, where we can see version one and version two, and so on and so forth. And I think that's everything that I wanted to talk about in terms of what's new in specific activities and settings. So just to summarize, we've gone through the site administration, new features, changes and improvements. And then we've looked at navigation, particularly from a student view, but of course the navigation applies to all, how teachers edit courses, and then improvements and new features within the activities in those courses. So that is the end of our presentation, but we still have time for some questions. So again, we're going to monitor the chat and see if you have anything else that you'd like to comment on or ask us about.
Thanks, Mary. I'm just scrolling back to where we finished before with the questions and trying to take them in order to not miss any out. So Sam was asking, has the hide but make an activity available changed? No, that should work exactly the same in 4.0 as in 3.11. Then Omid was asking, could we have a teacher demo account in a Moodle 4 site? And I noticed Anna replied saying you'll find information in the course on how and where to experience Moodle 4. So I encourage all of you after this session, when you have time later in the week, to come back to Academy and explore the course and find useful links and more resources. And also, if you want to watch the recording of this webinar.
We've a question, can you collapse all sections at once on the course index? I think so. I would have to go and do it to check in actual fact, but I don't see why not if you can do it on the course main page.
There's a few questions about Big Blue Button. Sabine is asking, where is it hosted or recorded? The company that provides Big Blue Button, Blindside Networks, provides the hosting for the basic level of Big Blue Button that you have free in Moodle 4.0. And that ties in with Sarah's question saying, is there a limit for the number of users in a session? And will there be any reports? So I encourage you to check the 4.0 documentation, because there has to be some limits on in the free version of Big Blue Button available in Moodle 4.0.
Okay, and Eugene says, what is going to be with the existing assignments where instructions are in the description field? Will they remain there after the upgrade? Yes. Anything that you've got in your assignment description will still be in the description, but of course you can then, if you want to, move it out of the description into the activity instructions box.
Bo is asking, has H5P as a standalone activity also have a passing grade feature in the activity completion section? Do you know the answer to this, Mary?
When you mean as a standalone activity, do you mean you don't mean using it as a plugin? If you mean using it within Moodle, since it's been integrated into Moodle, I'm fairly sure it also does have that passing grade feature. But of course, I will go and check immediately afterwards. In terms of using it as a plugin, again, I'm not sure, because I've not used it as a plugin, only within Moodle since it became part of Moodle.
Yeah, and one thing to note, if you're using H5P for grading, not all H5P content types provide grading information, so you need to check that.
Okay, Cindy's asking, can assignments auto-drip to the learners? I'm not quite sure what auto-drip means, but if you can explain, perhaps we can respond.
Yeah, sorry, Sabine was asking about question needs checking in a question bank. So this is set automatically based on question statistics. So if you have a question where students answer it, get high marks for it and for other questions in the quiz, then it's unlikely that it needs to be checked, But if you have a question where students do really well on it, but do badly in the rest of the quiz, then it's flagged as needs checking, because students get a very different result with that question compared with other questions. So it's all done automatically based on question statistics.
Okay, thank you. I think we'll take two more questions, and then I'm going to just do a couple of slides explaining about Academy, and then we'll finish. Stephen is asking, like custom reports, are there any other workplace specific features being included in LMS 4? Well, not in Moodle 4, the main feature from workplace is custom reports. However, as has been said over the last couple of years, with Moodle LMS, Moodle workplace features are regularly being incorporated into LMS, so you can look forward to other features as we go through later versions of Moodle 4. I don't quite know what yet, but it's always going to be something very good, like the custom reports are in 4.0.
And one last question from Cameron, asking about managing the question bank at site level. I'm not sure you can do that in 4.0, but I know that the team of people from different European universities have got a lot more improvements to the question bank planned for 4.1. So I'd encourage you to check the forums on Moodle.org to find out more.
Okay, thank you. Just finally, I think, Cindy, you explained that you meant assignments on a schedule. I'm not sure you can time schedule assignments. No, not within standard Moodle. If we didn't answer your question, or if you still have more questions, then we have a discussion forum in this course, Moodle 4 for Educators. Also, opening up straight after this webinar is Moodle 4 for Admins, if you'd like to go in there and explore the features that Helen talked about and join in the discussions there. So thank you very much for being part of this webinar. Moodle Academy runs regular webinars, but we rely on you to help by suggesting topic ideas that we can cover. We have a Get Involved course on the site where you can go and suggest. You might even like to contribute to a webinar by presenting, and we can bribe you with a presenter's badge. You might like to help contribute to courses if you have a lot of experience in course writing, and then you will get a course builder badge as well. So please think about those and help us spread the word. Tell your friends and colleagues about Moodle Academy, and also about the Moodle Educator Certification. So if you complete courses on Moodle Academy, you will earn badges. There's a badge both for the Moodle 4 for Educators and Moodle 4 for Admins courses. And also, if you are an educator, an experienced educator, then please explore the course. Are you ready for the MEC? And perhaps consider going and doing our Moodle Educator Certification Program via one of our certified Moodle providers. So I would just like to say thank you very much to everyone who's attended. And thank you, Helen, for joining me again. We're a good team. And thank you, everyone. And we hope you enjoyed this view on Moodle 4.